Welcome to a video on L'Hopital's rule, part 1. The goal of this video is to determine limits of indeterminate form using L'Hopital's rule. L'Hopital's rule, also called Bernoulli's rule, uses derivatives to evaluate limits involving indeterminate forms. These are the forms we're talking about when we refer to indeterminate forms. So you can see, in most cases, we'll be dealing with rational functions. Now, we have encountered limits involving indeterminate form before. For example, if we have the limit as x approaches 0 of x squared minus 3x divided by x squared plus 2x, we were able to evaluate this limit using algebraic techniques. Both the numerator and denominator can be factored, so we'd have the limit as x approaches 0 of x times x minus 3 divided by x times x plus 2. And now we can see there's a common factor of x here, which would simplify out. Remember, graphically, these common factors create holes in the function. And remember, holes do not affect limits. So now as x approaches 0, we can perform direct substitution. We would have 0 minus 3 over 0 plus 2, or negative 3 halves. Just to verify this, if you look at it graphically, we're approaching x equals 0, which is this vertical line here. And we can visually see, as we approach from the right and from the left, we are approaching a y value of negative 3 halves. And L'Hopital's rule gives us a different technique for evaluating limits of indeterminate form. L'Hopital's rule states the limit of a quotient is equal to the limit of the quotient of the derivatives under special conditions. And here are the special conditions. F and g are differentiable on an open interval, I, containing c, except possibly at c, and notice that c is the value that we're approaching. We also assume the derivative of g is not equal to 0 for all x in the interval, again, except possibly at c. So if these conditions are met, then the limit of the quotient as x approaches c produces an indeterminate form, then the limit of this quotient is equal to the limit of the quotient of the derivatives. And this is also true for a one-sided limits, and this rule can be applied more than once. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Now, all the limits we're going to look at do meet the conditions specified by L'Hopital's rule. But we still should check to make sure it's in the indeterminate form, as stated before. So here we have the same limit that we just looked at using an algebraic technique. But as x approaches 0, this is in the indeterminate form of 0 over 0. So we can apply L'Hopital's rule, which means this limit would be equal to the limit of the quotient of the derivatives. So the derivative of x squared minus 3x would be 2x minus 3. And the derivative of x squared plus 2x would be 2x plus 2. Now in this form, we can perform direct substitution. As x approaches 0, we'd have 0 minus 3 in the numerator, or negative 3. And our denominator would be 0 plus 2, which is equal to 2. So we get the same limit of negative 3 halves, this time using L'Hopital's rule. For this next limit, our numerator and denominator are also approaching 0. So let's apply L'Hopital's rule. The derivative of the numerator would be 2 minus the derivative of sine 2x. That would be cosine 2x times 2, applying the chain rule, or just 2 cosine 2x. The derivative of the denominator would be 1 plus 2 cosine 2x. Now as x approaches 0, cosine 2x approaches 1, so we'd have 2 times 2 times 1 all over 1 plus 2 times, again, cosine 2x approaches 1 as x approaches 0. So it looks like we have 0 over 3, which is equal to 0. Let's look at a few more examples here. The limit as x approaches infinity of natural log x divided by x. This would be in the form of infinity over infinity, which is indeterminate. So let's apply L'Hopital's rule. The derivative of natural log x would be 1 over x. Of course, the derivative of x would be 1. So the limit as x approaches infinity of 1 over x. Well, our numerator is fixed and our denominator is increasing, and when this is the case, this limit will equal 0. This next limit is in the indeterminate form of 0 over 0 as x approaches 0. So again, let's apply L'Hopital's rule. The derivative of sine 5x would be cosine 5x times 5, or 5 cosine 5x. Of course, the derivative of 3x would be 3. And as x approaches 0, cosine 5x approaches 1. So we have 5 times 1, or 5, over 3. So this limit is equal to 5/3. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more example for this video, and then we'll look at some different types in part 2. The current form of this limit does not fit the indeterminate form discussed before. As x approaches pi over 4, secant 2x approaches infinity, and 1 minus tangent x approaches 0 as x approaches pi over 4. So sometimes we have to manipulate the function in order to apply L'Hopital's rule. What I mean by that is we can rewrite secant 2x as 1 over cosine 2x. So this limit would be the same as x approaches pi over 4 of 1 minus tangent x divided by cosine 2x. Now both the numerator and denominator approach 0 as x approaches pi over 4, so we can apply L'Hopital's rule. The derivative of the numerator would be 0 minus secant squared x, or negative secant squared x. And the derivative of cosine 2x would be negative sine 2x times 2, or negative 2 sine 2x. Again, we applied the chain rule here. Now let's see what happens as x approaches pi over 4. Let's go ahead and start with the denominator. As x approaches pi over 4, 2x approaches pi over 2, and the sine of pi over 2 is equal to 1. So we'd have negative 2 times 1 in the denominator. And let's take a look at a reference triangle for the numerator. Pi over 4 is a 45 degree reference triangle, so the three sides would be 1, 1, square root 2. Remember, secant x is a reciprocal of cosine x. So cosine pi over 4 would be 1 over square root 2, which means secant pi over 4 would be equal to square root 2 over 1, or just square root 2. So we'll have negative and then square root 2 squared. So we're going to have negative 2 over negative 2. So this limit is equal to 1. This is going to do it for part 1. In part 2, we'll take a look at more types of limits like this, where we have to perform some extra steps before we can apply L'Hopital's rule. But before we go, let's go ahead and summarize. These are all the indeterminate forms of limits, and these here are considered determinant forms. So you may want to pause and take a look at these, but we will review these again in part 2. I hope you found this helpful, and thank you for watching.